Hey, YouTube friends. This video will be about religious comedy or Christian comedy. So these are all just things that I've thought of over the years. You know, questions that I would ask God someday. And I feel like I can make this video without making God too mad, because me and God are pretty close. So let's see. Here's one thing that I would ask God. I would say, you know how, like, you see those quotes sometimes, like, I know God won't give me more than I can handle. I just wish he didn't trust me so much. Yeah, I felt like that a lot in my life. You know, like God just trusts me just a little bit too much to endure some crazy thing, because I've had to endure a lot. Let me just preface this to say that, you know, when I was a kid, my dad sexually abused me. And then recently, my ex-husband went crazy. And, you know, I've just had a lot of things in my life, and I was crying about that. This part's not really funny, but I was crying about that about 6 months ago, and I was just like, I was talking to my stepdad about it, and I was like, why do things keep happening, you know? Haven't I had enough? But I think I would definitely, you know, want to ask God about that someday when I get to heaven, and I would just say, God, why did you let me go through so much stuff? I mean, I guess it's a compliment because you thought I was strong, but it still doesn't really make sense to me, you know? I mean, I really had a hard life. I mean, I guess it could have been harder, you know? At least I was born in the United States. I mean, that part was nice, but yeah. And then I think I would also ask God, you know, I've always had this question of the problem of evil and pain, and why does God allow pain and suffering, you know? I mean, I know it can make us stronger and give us endurance and work on our character, but I still think it doesn't make any sense because God loves us, but then, you know, it's like, but if you love me, why do you let me suffer so much, you know, and why do you let people suffer so much? And I mean, really a conclusion I've come to is that God just loves drama. Like, we like to watch movies. And our lives are kind of like a movie for God that he's watching, you know. And maybe it's like entertaining. Like, I don't want to sound disrespectful, but maybe it's like entertaining to God, you know, when we have kind of a hard life. Because maybe he's just always wanting to see, like, how we're going to respond and react to different situations, you know. Kind of like a scientist doing a lab test, you know. They might try to do the same thing on 10 different types of animals and then just see how they respond. It's kind of like that, but, you know, on a bigger scale. I don't know, you know, I mean, I got questions too, and now I got all these people on Twitter. There's all these atheist people, and they're like, you know, bashing me all the time, trying to say God doesn't exist, and the Bible's just fairy tales. And I mean, I can understand, like, you know, I can understand why people are mad at God, because there are things like that where it's like, yeah, why does God let this and that happen? You know, why does he let sexual abuse happen? Why does he let child abuse happen? I don't know. I'm sorry if this video isn't really funny yet, but this is more just my musings about Christianity. All right, let's see if I can come up with some funny stuff. All right. Well, one question that I would ask God when I get to heaven is why, okay, I got two big questions. My two biggest questions are, why did you wait so long to send Jesus to the earth? Because, you know, the Pharisees got everything all messed up. Like, why'd you wait so long? Why didn't you send Jesus sooner to straighten those people out? You know, because they were coming up with some crazy laws for the people and getting all prideful and stuff. And then my second question is that I would ask is, God, why did you wait so long for people to get the internet, you know? Because, I don't know, it's like, if you always had that in mind, to give the world the internet, why didn't you give human beings the idea sooner? Because I just can't imagine life without the internet. I mean, maybe it would be less stressful, because it would be more simple, but I think that it would be real sad, and I pretty much had the internet my whole life. I mean, ever since I was in, like, you know, fourth grade. And I just can't imagine life without the internet, because there's so much stuff you can learn. And I mean, you can look up anything you want to read about just, you know, within a second. And I think that's why my generation was like the smartest one, and then the ones after are smart because we can learn 24/7 about anything if we want to. You know, you can get on Wikipedia and read whatever you want. Of course, before the internet, people would just read an encyclopedia. But I just can't imagine people not having the internet, you know? And then, yeah, I guess I would ask too, like, why were people so primitive for so long, you know? Why did God not give humans the idea of indoor plumbing and all that sooner, you know? I don't know. I guess another question I would ask for God is, are we the only world, or are there like 100 worlds out there in the universe, you know? You know, the Bible doesn't mention it, but it's possible, you know, and I believe aliens could exist. I think that, you know, if I was God, I sure as heck would make more than one world. I would make 100, and then, you know, I wonder what the other worlds are like, you know, if people are making better choices and making better decisions, and maybe like there's one world where people don't do stupid stuff like getting into drugs and stuff and become alcoholics. I don't know. Like, I wonder if our world is the most messed up one. I don't know. Let's see. What other questions would I have forgot? Okay, here's a real big one that has always confused me. Why in the heck did God not keep the serpent out of the Garden of Eden? It's like, man, you know? Like, there's a part in Revelation about one third of the stars. That's the fallen angels, they fell down to the earth. But it's like, why'd you have to send them to the earth? Why couldn't you send them somewhere else? Why couldn't you tell them to not come here in the first place? You know, I mean, honestly, that's a big question I have. I don't mean to sound disrespectful, God, but I would definitely like to know why you let Satan come here in the first place. Because I think it would have been nice if Adam and Eve could have just been in the garden and not had some serpent climbing there and talk to Eve, you know. I'm just saying. If I would have created the world, I would have made sure that that serpent did not get in the Garden of Eden. That's just my thoughts on that. But I don't mean any disrespect to God. All right, let's see. What else is my question? I don't know. Here's something I've always thought of is that I bet after Adam followed his wife, you know, Eve gave him the fruit and he ate it. I bet he was like, man, I wish I would have just stayed in here alone. Like, why, God, why'd you give me this woman? Why couldn't it just been me and you? You know? I bet Adam was like, man, I should have just, man, why couldn't I just been in here alone? But you know, that makes me think of the verse in Corinthians. It says, those who marry will face many troubles in this life, and I wish to spare you of this. That's a real verse in the Bible, and that is so true because when you get married, you got a lot more problems than you had when you were single, theoretically. I mean, you got more money because you got a dual income, but you know, you got like more stress. You know, you got to buy more groceries and food because there's two of you. And you know, sometimes you guys don't agree on things, like, you know, and you just got to deal with that and compromise. So that's why Paul says it's better to stay single because it's kind of easier sometimes, but it just depends. Let's see, what other questions would I have? I guess another big question I would have for God is, why don't you just blow this planet up? I mean, you see how evil it is, right? You see all the human trafficking, child trafficking, drugs, alcohol, rape, murder. It's like, honestly, if I was God, I would have blown this planet up a long time ago, maybe like in the 60s. But for some reason, he lets people keep living and keep sinning and keep being mean to people. And I don't know why, you know, except for that one verse that, you know, God wants all people to come to repentance and to be saved. So he's just giving people more time. But I'm like, I don't know. I wouldn't have given people that much time. I would have been like, you know, I can't be that patient with all this evil in the world, you know. But then I guess maybe God tries to focus on the positive, and he looks at the people who are good, like me, trying to make these videos, like Joyce Meyer and Joel Osteen, you know, and all the pastors all over America trying to make a difference. And he's like, well, I'm gonna say the good outweighs the bad, and I'm gonna keep the world spinning and keep people alive. But for real, like if I was God, I mean, I would have blown this planet up a long time ago because it's just like, it's so dark and it's so evil and people are so cold, you know. But there's a verse about that. It says that, you know, in the last days, the love of many will grow cold and people will be like egotistical and they won't love other people. They'll only love themselves. So that's why our world is so hard. But those are all the questions that I would have for God. And I hope they didn't seem disrespectful at all. I didn't mean to disrespect you, Jesus, God, and Holy Spirit. Anyways, I'm sure you all got your own questions that you would like to talk to God about someday when you see him in heaven. And I think y'all should make a video about your own questions because why not? It's very therapeutic. Yes. All right. Well, God loves you all. And I hope you have a great day. Goodbye.